Hi, this is Steve DeMasi, and welcome to Uncharted DIY. Today we're in my office, and boy is it hot in here. Now, I've got this great portable air conditioner, but the problem is it has to be vented outside, and it only comes with a 4-foot hose that can't be extended, and this doesn't come anywhere close to reaching my window. So I had to come up with a way to vent it directly through the wall as unobtrusively as possible, and that's what today's project is all about. Let me show you how this works. I didn't want a big hole in the wall when I'm not using the air conditioner, and in the winter time I didn't want all the heat escaping, so I had to come up with a way to insulate it. So what I've done here is I've got a magnetic cover that comes off of here, and inside here is just some black foam rubber insulation. This is just 1-inch foam that I'm using for insulation, and I've cut it down into smaller pieces so it's easy to take in and out. But really the only time you need to do this is when you're setting it up for the winter time. Now, if you want to close this vent without putting all the insulation in it, you can just take this magnetic cover and cover the hole like that. Now, what I did here was I took the plastic frame that usually goes in the window and embedded it directly into the wall so that this still fits into it perfectly. Now, I made my cover out of a flexible material, and I put magnets on the back of it. And then, before I sunk this into the wall, I put magnets on the back of it inside here. And that way, when I need to put this on, it just adheres like that. So when I'm ready to run the air conditioner, I just pull this panel off of here, and I can plug the hose directly into this. And there we go. Then when I'm ready to put this away for the season, I just take it back out, put the foam insulation back in, and cover it with the magnetic cover. Okay, the first step in this process is figuring out exactly where I want this vent to go in the wall. Now, I happen to be in a tri-level, and this is the lower level. So I know that somewhere in here, I've got a concrete wall and then nothing above it, just regular framing. And so I need to determine exactly where the hole is going to go, not only in terms of the vertical studs, but also where this wall begins. So I haven't cut this plate yet, and I'm not going to until I've figured out exactly where everything is. But this kind of shows you, I'm looking at putting this someplace along in this wall like that. So I need to use the stud sensor. You can see there's a stud there, and a stud there. Okay, I'd say that's pretty conclusive exactly where that concrete is. So let's mark that. Now, because I know on the other side of this wall I'm going to have the vent, I don't want that to be right at the transition where the concrete and the siding of the house begins, because then I'll have this weird grill just hanging halfway off the siding. So my concrete ends here. I'm going to put it right about here, which will give me plenty of room for that vent cover on the outside. This is my opening, and I just need to decide what's going to look the nicest. So I think tucked up under the whiteboard is going to look pretty nice here and pretty unobtrusive. I'm just going to eyeball that, get it pretty much in the center, and then trace through here. That's where the hole is going to go. Now, I already checked carefully both outside and inside if there are any outlets or any sort of electricity running through this wall, any plumbing, any gas lines, anything like that. And there should be absolutely nothing there. But before I go and I cut this large hole in here anyway, I'm just going to drill a pilot hole and make sure that this is an open area. The other thing is, I don't know how deep this wall is. I thought I could tell by looking at the window frames, but the window frame in this office is only about this deep, yet the two windows in the room across from this one, which also share this wall, are about that deep. And so I have no idea how deep this wall actually is. So that's going to be one of the things I'm going to find out with this pilot hole. I'm going to drill a hole in this side with the spade bit, and then I'm just going to put a tiny one through the actual siding just to make sure that I like exactly where this is coming out. That's definitely the deeper of the two walls. What I'm going to do is just drill a small hole using just a small bit. And that way, if it's not where I want it to come out, I don't have a huge hole to patch. So I can see there's a little pinhole of daylight there, so I know I got through the siding. So let's go outside and see what I got. So I can see where this hole came out on the outside. That's going to provide plenty of room for the outside cover. Okay, now with this traced out, I can see the size of the hole that I need to cut to sink this into, but it's also the exterior measurement for the duct box that I'm going to build. Next, I'm going to drill holes in the corners, the four corners, and that way I can again use my long bit and drill through and determine exactly where I need to cut on the outside. Now before I go outside and cut anything, I'm going to go ahead and finish cutting out this hole on the inside. Phew. One downside of this is this office is going to be dusty. The plan is to build a duct box with a frame or lip. This lip is how it's attached to the siding, and a soffit cover mounts on it. The portion of the box that goes inside the wall has the same dimensions as the faceplate that usually goes in the window. The plate overlaps the inside edge of the duct box and makes a surface for the plate to be mounted into the wall. I'm going to cut this down so that it's even on both sides. I'm using a miter saw, but a circular saw or a hand saw would work just as well for this. The trick to cutting plastic with the miter saw is to just go nice and slow. Let the blade do the work. Looks great. I know I want this box to be exactly the same dimensions as the outside of this piece. My depth from the outside of the siding to the inside of the drywall is 9 3/8. Because I've got so many projects going on, my table saw is buried, so I'm going to use just a plain old handheld circular saw to do this cutting with, because it's really simple cutting. Then I need the 12-inch pieces. Since the faceplate is 4 inches tall and the boards are 1/2 inch thick, I'm going to make the sides 3 inches. Okay, this soffit vent cover is what I'm going to use on the outside to keep bugs out of there. As you see, it's already pre-screened. The soffit cover is 8 inches, and the box is 4 inches. And because the box is made of 1/2 inch boards, I want that lip to overlap that 1/2 inch. So the boards I'm going to cut for the lips will be 2 1/2 inches. Now we have the pieces to build the box. Go like that and double check our sizing. Looks great. So we'll assemble this into a box and then we will attach the lips and we'll be ready to put this in the wall. What I intend to do is use a brad nailer, but you could use nails or you could drill pilot holes and put thin screws in there. You have to be careful because 1/2 inch of particle board is not all that thick, so you want to make sure that whatever you drive into here doesn't split the wood. This frame is the part that's going to go outside on the wall. And then this side is going to go inside like this. Now, as you can see, I've got a little bit of a gap here, and I'm going to make some spacers so that when I put a couple screws in here, it's not going to make this bow down. I'll measure the distance between the top of this and the underside of this. And I'm going to make two little spacers. This will sit exactly like this and be perfectly flush with the wall. Even the small drill poked some big holes in this siding coming out this way. So you can see why I didn't want to come out with a spade bit and have it tear apart some of this siding, which has got to hold up until I can actually replace it, because it's in pretty bad shape. I can use my panel, which is the exact same size as the box, to trace out exactly where I'm going to cut this. The corner holes are too small to fit the jigsaw blade into, so I'm going to start in a large hole in the center and work my way out. Okay, well, it fit through to the other side perfectly, and it's all lined up in there. Looks great. You can see there's a bit of a gap between the frame and the siding, and that's because of the tilt of the siding. So I'm going to custom cut some wood wedges just to tighten up and get rid of that extra gap in there. And here it is with it all caulked and ready to go. The soffit cover is on there to keep bugs out, and it's caulked all the way around the edges, so we shouldn't be having any ants or anything crawling in there. All I need to do now is wait for that caulking to dry and I can paint it to match. To create the magnetic cover, I used a flexible magnetic backing sheet, thinking that it would be strong enough to hold on to the magnets that were embedded in the back of the faceplate, but it turns out they weren't. However, I still like the flexibility and the color of it, so I attached additional magnets to it, which made it stick really well. The first thing I did was I took the faceplate and laid it face down. Then I adhered some self-adhesive magnets to the back of it. Now, with the faceplate facing up, I let the magnetic force snap additional magnets into place, this time with the adhesive facing up. Once the adhesive backing paper is peeled back, I flip the whole faceplate over and press it down onto the flexible cover, which adheres the magnets to the cover. This way everything is aligned perfectly without having to measure anything. After putting the magnets in place, I attach the faceplate to the box embedded in the wall. Then I caulked around the edges and then spackled. Now, once I finish painting the office, this should completely disappear into the wall. This cover can be made out of any material that's best going to match your situation. Oh, now with this running, it's so much cooler in here, and I can get some work done. This is Steve, and thanks for watching Uncharted DIY. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe, and leave questions and comments below. And if you try this project, now on UnchartedDIY.com, you can share pictures and comments on your project. And also check out UnchartedDIY.com, where you'll find further information and more detailed how-to projects.